Estimating a path model with SPSS. This diagram of a path model summarizes our hypotheses. We have newspaper reading time as the final outcome variable, and we have age as the predictor. Education, political interest, and news site use are mediators. We cannot estimate this model in one go in process, because there is both serial mediation, from age to education to political interest to reading time, and there is parallel mediation, because news site use also mediates the effect of age on reading time. We can estimate this model in SPSS as a series of regression models. For each variable in the path model that can be an outcome variable in a regression, we must estimate a regression model. So that will be four regression models. From right to left, the first model would have newspaper reading time as the outcome variable. The second one would have news site use as the outcome variable. Political interest would be the outcome variable in the third model. And the fourth and final model would have education as the outcome variable. Let's estimate some of these models. Let's start with the regression model for newspaper reading time. Under Analyze Regression Linear, we select reading time as the dependent variable, age as the independent variable, and we select the moderators also as predictors, so education, political interest, and news site use. As statistics, we like to have the confidence intervals. We create some plots to check the assumption for regression analysis. And then we paste and run the command. Let's focus on the standardized coefficients because process doesn't calculate those for us. We see that age has a strong positive effect on newspaper reading time. Education level and interest in politics hardly have an effect on newspaper reading time. And news site use has a weak to moderate negative effect. Do we meet the requirements for regression analysis? Let's have a look at the residuals. The residuals are normally distributed, so that's okay. And the residuals are nicely distributed above and below zero at different levels of the predicted value. And the variation in the residuals is more or less equal for low, medium, or high levels of the predicted value. So we have reasons to believe that we fulfill the assumptions for regression analysis. Now we can enter the standardized coefficients to a path model. Here they are. Well, as a next step, let's estimate the regression model with new sites used as outcome variable. Again, regression linear. I will remove reading time as a dependent variable. I'll remove news site as a predictor and use it as a dependent variable. That's all we have to do. Let's paste and run the command and again focus on the standardized coefficients. We see a strong negative effect of age on news site use and weak positive effects of education and interest in politics. We can add the standardized coefficients to our path model. And then we inspect the residuals. The residuals are nicely normally distributed, so that's okay again. The outcome variable is not really a continuous variable, and therefore the residuals are now lined up in strips, so it's a bit more difficult to see whether the averages are around zero at different levels of the predicted value. And also it's more difficult to see whether the variation in the residuals is more or less equal at different levels of the predicted value. At the far left and the right, we seem to have less variation than in the middle. So it's not quite clear that we fulfill the assumptions here. In this way, we could continue with a regression model with political interest as an outcome variable, and then a regression model with education as an outcome variable. I trust that you can do that by yourself. The standardized coefficients are added to the path diagram. And if we now want to calculate the size of indirect effects, we can multiply the direct effects. However, we do not know the confidence intervals or the p-values of the indirect effects. These cannot be calculated in SPSS.